Welcome back to Scorecard Sense. It's Jekko and Lani, and today we're using these bars because we were looking at
this.
Dips are great for building up strength, particularly in the front of your shoulder and your triceps. And so we're going to show you how to get the set position correct to start you off with, and then look at some strength progressions you can build through safely and effectively as you build up that strength.
Yes, we're going to look at the positioning of your shoulders and your elbows through the movement of the dip.
And it's really important that you look at that technique, because if we don't get the technique right, then things ain't going to be nice. This set position then that Lani's going to show us is all about creating tension through the shoulder. So in between the parallel bars, what we're not trying to do is we're not going to be slumped in this position where the shoulder is up by the ear. Well, that's not going to be good enough. We need to get active through that position. We're going to actively push down, what we call this active pushing position, so that we're not just pushing down, we're also getting a bit of retraction, so pulling the shoulder blades together at the back. That then creates a nice stable position for the shoulder, so when we drop down to that dip, we're getting that good technique that Lani's talking about with the shoulder and the elbow pointing backwards. So build up some strength and being able to hold that position, keep that separation from the shoulder and the ear, and build up some time under tension there, 5, 10, 20, up to 30 seconds if you can, to get yourself set up for the beginning.
And also when I'm lowering down, I'm still engaging and pushing against these bars as I'm going down.
Yeah, so just because you're lowering yourself, you're not slumping and letting that tension go from your shoulder. Otherwise, you're going to lose that position. When you lose that position, you're going to lose the strength. The first strength exercise then we're going to give you is this angled push-up position, where the hands are higher up off the floor, but it's going to give us a chance to look at the good pushing mechanics we need in this dip. So Lani's going to get those shoulders set in that correct position to start with, where she's getting a little bit of a pinch between her shoulder blades at the back. But as she lowers down now, we're keeping that retraction of the shoulders, keeping that separation there, but we've also now importantly got the elbows pointing backwards. What we don't want to do in terms of your body alignment is we drop into the bottom. If you're finding that you're struggling strength-wise from your shoulders and your triceps, this bum will kick backwards and then you'll just actually push your bum back rather than actually driving yourself up. So what we want to make sure we're doing as we're dropping down, rib cage is locked down, abs are tight, bum's tight. So as she drives back, keeping those elbows tight to the body, the whole body moves as one away from the bars.
Now we're going to focus on doing the full movement of the dip, so lowering all the way down and then coming back up. I've chosen a slightly thicker band to give me a little bit more assistance. So same again, on top.
Yeah, bangers on top, hands on top, dead simple. Don't start tying it in knots and doing all sorts of funky things with it. Just put the hands on top. Technique's all the same. Getting yourself a slightly thicker band is just going to give you a little bit more help on the way when you drive back up. So we've still got that control on the way down, creating that set position. Shoulder not driving up by ear, elbows pointing nicely backwards, loading up the triceps, and then driving back up. Lani was then going to try and put together sort of 3 to 5 reps of these if they've been working on our sort of maximum strength or applied strength part of our framework. And what you're going to then do is start to work down as you get stronger week by week, use a thinner and thinner and thinner band until you're not having to do any whatsoever. Beautiful.
So there we have it. There are a few tips on how you can build up the strength to doing your first dip unassisted. And it's all about focusing on that technique.
Yeah, and these are a great one to get mastered and get in your locker, because the basic strength that you can develop and the technique for all of your pushing-based movements are grounded in having good quality strength dips for those strong shoulders, strong triceps. So if you haven't subscribed yet, you need to get doing that. That's up by Lani's head there. If you haven't got our free beginner's guide, it's got loads of tutorials in there to help you get started on your calisthenics journey down there. And for one of our other tutorials that you might have missed, that's up there. So until next time.
Class dismissed.